Hello everybody. Organization and management of early childhood education centers. Today under this, we are going to deal with the topic material management in early childhood education programs. The objective of this lesson is to understand the material management of early childhood education programs. Material management is an approach for planning, organizing and controlling all those activities principally concerned with the flow of material into an organization. Material management varies greatly from one organization to another and may include the material planning, controlling, production planning, purchasing, inventory control and in-plant material movement and waste management. In any business organization, the functioning of planning, purchasing, moving, storing material is an optimum way which helps the organization to minimize the various costs like inventory, purchasing, material handling and distribution cost. The fundamental objectives in material management are acquisition of material and services of the right quality, in right quantity, at the right time, and from the right source and at the right price. The teaching and learning materials, whether we are purchasing them or we are getting in donation, should be selected and accessed in the ways which are directly related to the preschool or the school curriculum policy and program, basing on the department's framework of the standards and accountability, and also include where relevant and support for the recreational needs of the children takes place. It should be supporting an inclusive curriculum, thus helping the children and the students to gain an awareness of the pluralistic society and importance of respectful relations with each other. The materials should motivate the children and the educators to examine their own attitudes and behaviors and comprehend their duties, responsibilities and rights and privileges as the citizens of the society. The materials are relevant for the age of the children for whom they are selected and for their emotional, intellectual, social and cultural development. The materials should provide opportunities for children to find, use, evaluate the present information and to develop critical capacities to make discerning choices so that they are prepared for exercising their freedom of access with discrimination as informed and skilled adults. So, this is the importance of materials in a child education centers. After having understood the importance of materials, let us now see how the arrangements depending on the needs of the child. There are three major areas to equip in a child care center, and a director must determine the type and amount of the equipment needed for these areas. The areas are the children's space, both indoor and outdoor space, the adult spaces, which includes the office rooms, the waiting rooms, the conference rooms, and the lounge areas and service areas. Equipment not only includes the classroom material, but furniture, but also consumable supplies such as paints, paper towels, the food and stationery items. The equipment and supplies budget should provide for a initial purchase as well as for the long and short term replacement of both basic furnishings and consumable supplies. The first area is the children's space. The program philosophy and the needs of the children indicate what will be ordered for the children's space in the center. Most programs are set up in a basic curriculum areas like the art, music, science, manipulations, dramatic play and area for pre-academic material relating to language and maths. All these curricular areas require special furnishings and materials. Provision must be made for water and sand play also, and material should be required for building the large muscle activities. Furniture for working, resting and eating are also needed, including accessories like the cloths, paints, waste baskets and curtains, etc. So, this is about the equipment required in a children's space. Then coming to adult spaces. Even a small center requires some office space, a locked file cabinets for records at a very minimal need. If a separate room is not available, it is preferable to eliminate having a desk for teacher since it will be taking so much of the children's play space. Furthermore, the effective teacher of the young children does not like to use a desk while working with the children. So, paperwork can be done after the child nap or after the school. So, when planning for a office space, providing a basic furniture for each occupant like some two chairs and a desk, a file cabinet or a shelf will be done. A desk and cabinet can be shared by other teachers who will be having most of the time in the classroom. A computer or a calculator will be also useful equipment in an office room. The director for large centers find that copying machines are better than investing in terms of money and time in duplicating such things like the newsletters or worksheets or application forms. So, in big centers, they can go for a larger equipment. Then comes the staffing needs for meetings. When the staff meetings are held after the children leave the classrooms can be used for meetings. However, it is generally more comfortable for the adults who might be attending the meeting in a space furnished with adult-sized chairs and tables rather than the children's classrooms. Comfortable furniture should be provided so that they can also be used by parents who come to the centers for conferences or for consulting the staff members or teachers. So, this is about the adult spaces and the equipment required by them. Then comes the service areas. The basic equipment in the bathroom, in the kitchen is usually inbuilt and need not be purchased from the equipment or supplies budget. However, consumable areas that has to be purchased are like the dishes, cutlery, cooking utensils should be purchased when you are planning to have a lunch for the children in the center. So, this is about the children, adult and service area spaces required and the materials needed. So, after having understood the importance of materials in an organization and establishing these materials according to the needs of the person in the early childhood education centers, let us now move on to see how the equipment can be selected. What is the criteria when we are selecting equipment for early childhood education center? The selection of equipment should be based on some pre-established criteria. The primary consideration is usefulness. That means whether a piece of equipment will meet the needs of the centers or not should be assessed. The other criteria will be the suitability, durability, economy, ease of maintenance, attractiveness, teacher preferences and safety while using this equipment. The goals and objectives of that particular center will indicate some purchases. A center that emphasizes academic development, which is focusing on maths and problem solving, will purchase a wide variety of material suitable for teaching mathematics in the class. Next comes the usefulness. The criteria while selecting the equipment. The usefulness of the equipment can be measured first by how well it meets the developmental needs of the children in the program and second by whether the equipment has multiple uses. The next criteria that can be used while selecting the equipment is the developmental needs. Then developmental needs, capabilities and the age range of the children enrolled will be influencing the purchase of the equipment in the center. The young children need some pull toys, small climbers, small furnitures like the cribs, the changing tables or rocking chairs that are not needed by the other children or older children. Sometimes the infants require washable toy sheets or blankets, nursing bottles and disposable diapers. When you are planning for a toddler, you might be needing the potty chairs instead of inbuilt equipment which are unsuitable for toilet training. So, these children should also be provided with material for filling and dumping with sufficient number so that sharing will be easy. So, we have understood that the equipment when purchasing, we have to take care what are the needs of the children to whom we are catering. If we are having a school aged children, then we will be needing some games and crafts that are too far complex and frustrating for young children. They may also need a well lighted working areas for homework and large furniture in which they can sit and work comfortably, and activities or equipments for semi organized sports are also required when the center is catering to the school age child. The next selection criteria depends upon the multiple use or multi-purpose equipment. A piece of equipment that can be used in several ways is bonus financially and also in the terms of enriched learning experiences for the children. Such equipment not only saves the space, money, but also gives the children the opportunity to use their imagination in creating different foundations for one object. An example is a large hollow blocks that can be used to make a puppet stage or sometimes for a grocery store, or it can also serve as an individual workspace when the children are working on small projects. Both large pieces of equipment and small pieces of equipment can serve multi-purpose. A bookshelf can be used as a room divider and also a storage facility. The rings on a ring stack can be placed on the post by a 2-year-old and can be used for a color discrimination for a 3-year-old, and can be organized in a variety of classification and seriation exercise when you are working with a 4-year-old child. The next important criteria when selecting the equipment is its suitability. Some equipment must be provided in several sizes. The specific equipment must be provided to meet the needs of each user. For example, children must have a standard sized chairs around 10, 12 or 14 inches high depending on their height and age. The next criteria is stereotypes. The equipment must be chosen with understanding that it may be used equally by all children. The staff members who plan curriculum in a stereotyped way will need some special guidance on this point so that the boys are not committed to playing with the blocks only, and while the girls are not always expected to dress the dolls and play quiet table games. The material provided should reflect many cultures and should depict a variety of roles being chosen by a number of various cultures and by both genders. The next important criteria while selecting the equipment is special needs. In determining the suitability of equipment, we must consider the children with handicaps also. The children who cannot walk, for example, may need easels and water tables that can be used while the children sit in a chair or a wheelchair, and the length of the children's arms should be taken care of. In this way, we can determine the optimum height of the working spaces for such children with special needs. Then comes the types of services. Finally, suitability issue relates to overall type of the services that is being provided in the center. The children in a daycare center may need equipment that substitute for items that are normally found in home, whereas a child who attends a preschool class 2 or 3 mornings a week may be involved with a different type of equipment. For example, a daycare children may have a little opportunity to ride a bicycle at home or to do simple cooking activities because they are often not involved in day-to-day routines of home equipment, furnishings and clothing. Next comes the durability and economy. Durability and economy often go hand in hand. When more durable items are purchased, the center is not faced with the problem of replacement very often, and considerable importing costs are saved, particularly with large pieces of equipment. Then the next criteria while selecting the equipment is ease of maintenance. Ease of maintenance should also be considered while we are choosing the equipment, especially in equipment like the sinks, toilets, the drinking fountains that must be cleaned daily, and the tabletops that must be washed several times in each day. They should be extremely simple and easy to clean. The outdoor equipment. The outdoor equipment can be repainted frequently. Should be designed so that it can be painted very easily. The surfaces that catch and hold stains, the places which are difficult to reach, increase the need of maintenance. Equipment that will rust very easily should not be purchased for the outdoor use. The next criteria is attractiveness. The child care center equipment should be well designed and aesthetically attractive. Most parents and teachers would like their children to appreciate beauty, and one of the best ways we can help the children acquire this aesthetic appreciation is to surround them with beauty. And attractive equipment also carries a subtle message that the children who enter the settings are much appreciated and that great care is to be taken to make their environment beautiful. Next is the safety. The equipment must be safe. Though it is versatile, attractive, durable, economy and suitable, it should be made of non-toxic material, and the equipment should not have sharp or pointed edges. So these are the things we have to keep in mind while we are selecting equipment for our early childhood education centers. After having understood the need for managing materials in an early childhood education center and the criteria for selecting the equipment, let us now have a look at managing the equipment. There are a number of important things to be considered after the equipment is delivered to the center. The equipment must be checked and before it is stored, and a maintenance plan should be set up to minimize their repairs and replacement needs. Checking and inventorying the equipment. When equipment is received, it must be checked against in the terms of the quantity, the size, color and so forth. It is also important to make certain that only the items actually received are listed both on the order and packing slip and that the prices are correct. If any differences are found, the vendor must be notified immediately, and it is wise to keep the original packing material in case the equipment needs to be returned. Maintaining and storing the equipment. As soon as the equipment is placed in the center, the job of maintenance begins. The equipment used by the children must be checked daily, and if it needs some repairs or it has to be replaced, that should be taken care as soon as possible. The children need attractive, usable equipment. Puzzles with missing pieces, bikes with missing pedals, or books with torn pieces should not be left in the classroom. The storage of equipment is also directly related to its maintenance. It is easy to replace equipment after it has been used at a clearly known space in the storage room. Each center must work out a method for storing the certain equipment that are used daily and which must remain in the classroom itself. Other supplies should be returned to the central areas. The storage must also provide for items like the tricycles that are used daily and must be protected from theft. So, this is about managing the equipment. After having understood the importance of material management in early childhood education center and the criteria for selecting the equipment and managing the equipment, now we will see what are the centers or the learning centers where the equipment are required. When designing a developmentally appropriate curriculum for a preschool, the learning centers are the major considerations. Rooms are commonly divided into learning centers, which provide for a variety of learning opportunities for the children to maximize their interest and engagement. Each child has an opportunity to solve the problems, to exchange ideas with the peers, and to learn social behavior. The learning centers should provide opportunities for children to work at their own interest levels and at their own space. An effective teacher is ever present to bring about individual learning through teacher-guided interactions and activities. Most activities are typically child-initiated, and some planned activities will require the teacher initiativeness or the teacher involvement to take advantage of the teachable moments or develop interest among the children. While many of the materials in learning centers will remain consistent throughout the year, some may have to be rotated regularly to maintain the child's interest. Basing on the planned curriculum, the teacher will be selecting the specific activities to support the child's learning. These should be planned ahead of time based on child's interest and ability levels. Learning centers provides the child with flexibility in time spent on activity, the freedom to participate in a variety of self-selected activities. The common learning centers. There are some common learning centers which are often seen in almost all the early childhood education centers. Here, the learning centers provide the structure for the rest of the class. The size of the class, the number of the children enrolled will inform the number of centers that might be included in the early childhood education centers. While there should be a minimum of at least 5 learning centers, the classroom which has got more space will be having more or many centers as possible so that it can offer a variety of self-centered activities. The centers for learning in the early childhood programs can be a block center, a dramatic play center, art center, manipulative center, literacy books or library, a science or discovery center, the music and movement center, the sand and water play center, a computer center, and an outdoor area center. What are the general arrangements when having these learning centers in an early childhood education program? The classroom should include a balance of areas for attractive play and areas for quiet play. Messy activity areas like the art and science and meals should be very near to water access so that it will be easy in cleaning up. The hand washing sink for toileting or diapering should separate sink should be used while having a food preparation. The furniture should be arranged to help reduce the runways so that they minimize the child running around in the classroom. It will be making it easy for the children to get around. The materials for the children should be organized and stored to provide an easy access for the child. All the child accessible materials should be of age appropriate, clean and in a good condition. Each child should have an area for storing his personal items. The materials which are not appropriate for children should be stored in a high or a locked cabinet to prevent any kind of injury. Each classroom should also include a parent communication area so that a parent or teacher communication can be encouraged. Each classroom should have at least 5 learning centers. One of them can be a cozy place. In addition to all these mentioned above, the teacher should also consider several key questions to make sure that the room arrangement and selecting material which are appropriate for the children and also appropriate to the classroom. So, what can be the dimensions of a room? What can be the window size or the door size? Where the sinks or toilets should be placed? How many children can occupy this space? And what are the ages of the children who will be coming into this room? All these questions should be considered by the staff or the teachers or whoever is responsible when selecting the materials for the children. So, today we have understood how the material flow takes place in an organization like the Early Childhood Education Center. We went on to understand how the equipment or the material will be influencing the development of the children in an early childhood education programs. We went on to understand what are the criteria we have to consider while selecting equipment for an early childhood education programs. And then we also understood how the equipment after purchased has to be maintained. And then we have seen what are the learning centers possible in early childhood education programs and the materials required in such learning centers and how the teacher is responsible for arranging the classroom. Hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.